You are the librarian. Perhaps you will permit us to examine the work of the two unfortunates that were so distressingly gathered under guard.
Your request is most unusual.
As are the circumstances of their deaths.
Brother Adelmo sat there.
Thank you. Abbott is a monkey. He really had a daring talent for comic images.
Per Bavana, altri sui, opten and loqui.
I trust my words did not offend you, Brother William, but I heard persons laughing at laughable things. You Franciscans, however, belong to an order where merriment is viewed with indulgence.
Yes, it's true. St. Francis was much disposed to laughter.
Laughter is a devilish wind, which deforms the lineaments of the face and makes men look like monkeys.
Monkeys do not laugh. Laughter is particular to man.
As a sin. Christ never laughed.
Can we be so sure?
There is nothing in the scriptures to say that he did.
And there's nothing in the scriptures to say that he did not. Why, even the saints have been known to employ comedy to ridicule the enemies of the faith. For example, when the pagans plunged St. Maurus into the boiling water, he complained that his bath was too cold, the sultan put his hand in and scalded himself.
A saint immersed in boiling water does not play childish tricks. He restrains his cries and suffers for the truth.
And yet, Aristotle devoted his second book of Poetics to comedy as an instrument of truth.
You have read this work?
No, of course not. It's been lost for many centuries.
No, it has not. It was never written. Because Providence doesn't want futile things glorified.
Oh, that I must contest.
Enough! This abbey is overshadowed by grief. Yet you would intrude on our sorrow with idle banter.
Forgive me, Venerable Jorge. My remarks were truly out of place. Which was the Greek translator's desk?
This one.
Come, Adam.